is one of their lucky moments. My staff just told me that they called a vote, so I will be very brief. Again, my name is Tony Cardenas, but I've been elected to office now 20 years. I was 6 years in the State Assembly in California, 10 years on the LA City Council, and now I'm going on 4 years here in Congress. Why is that relevant to everybody in this room? I happen to be an electrical engineer. And because of that, yes, because of that, everybody assumed that was the issue I wanted to work on. So every time I get elected to office, I get put on the committees or chair the committee that oversees renewable energy issues and energy in general. When I was in the state legislature, the 6 years I was there, I was on the Utilities and Commerce Committee. And at one point, the Democrats only had a one vote margin in the House. So that suited me just fine because I got to sway the final decisions based on my one vote. And so I was very fortunate to work on energy issues at that level, especially renewable energy, being California, constantly trying to pave the way for good policy. In addition to that, when I got to the City Council in Los Angeles, I chaired the committee that oversaw the Department of Water and Power. And so it should be good news to you that, well, the bad news when I got there was that they did not have a renewable portfolio standard at the Department of Water and Power, the largest in the country. So within one, I told them, within 1 year, you will have one, and we will embark on that journey. And before I left the City Council, we went way below the 50% mark of getting our energy from coal. When I got there, it was way above 50%, and we were able to actually close down some coal plants, and we were also able to make sure that we added renewable energy of every kind in the city of Los Angeles. And now that I'm in Congress, I'm on the Energy and Commerce Committee, and I have introduced some bills that hopefully will see the light of day soon that have to do with making sure we have renewable energy and to the choice of consumers, whether you live in an apartment, whether you have money or not, you should be able to put your money where your mouth is and be able to say, I want my energy to be clean energy, renewable energy. And the last thing I want to say, one of my objectives is to make sure that we understand that in this country, on a per capita basis, we have this highest appetite for consuming energy. So the cleanest energy is energy we don't use. So that's one of my mantras, to try to remind people that let's be mindful. Let's try to teach ourselves and our children and our businesses and everybody to say, let's be as efficient as possible and let's enjoy the future. And as we all know, I think that most everybody in this room, it's not a controversial thing to say that global warming is real. And one of the things that we need to make sure that we understand is that we don't contribute to that future in that way that we diminish the possibility of it having the detrimental effects that we all believe and know about. So thank you so much for everything that you do every single day. Thank you.
Thank you, Congressman.